Hello, my name is Carl Thomson, and today I'm going to show you how to shoot a time lapse of the night sky using your DSLR to hopefully achieve images just like this. I'm based here in Manchester, England, and there's way too much light pollution to try and capture a decent shot of the night sky. So over the Christmas break, when I was visiting my parents, I was lucky enough to get a shot of thousands, if not millions of stars in rural Lincolnshire. The first thing you need is a camera that's gonna shoot long exposures and a nice sturdy tripod. I'm using the Canon 6D, the Tamron's 24-70mm 2.8, and this is a Manfrotto with a 501 fluid head. And I use an intervalometer, or remote control, whatever you want to call it. When shooting the stars, you want as much light to hit your camera sensor as possible. I was shooting raw so that I could push the image in post-production later on, and everything's set up in manual mode. I open my aperture fully to f2.8. I set my ISO to 2500. This is a full frame camera, which is happily gonna handle 2500 ISO. If you're using a crop sensor, such as a 7D, then you're not likely gonna go above 1600, 2000 tops, otherwise you're gonna really induce a lot of noise into your images. I then set my exposure time to 30 seconds. That means when I hit the shutter button, the iris opens for an entire 30 seconds, letting all this light stream in, it then shuts. That's one photo. When it comes to picking your exposure time for shooting the stars, I wouldn't necessarily go above 30 seconds for one still image, because you're probably gonna get what's known as a star trail, which is where the Earth's rotation actually affects the image and your stars travel across the shot. Obviously, I don't wanna sit here pressing the shutter every 30 seconds, so I use what's called an intervalometer. Now they vary in price. This one's about £15 from Amazon. You can get Canon ones, which are almost 10 times that, but I've used this for a year and it's served me really well. Now there's a bunch of settings on here that I'm not gonna go into too much detail. The most important one we need to know about is the interval. Now when shooting stars, I typically set the interval between 3 and 5 seconds. That means we take one photo, the intervalometer counts for 5 seconds, then takes another photo. You hit start and you leave your camera. If you're shooting crowds of people whizzing by, you may want to set the interval to just 1 second. If you're shooting a construction site, you may want to set the interval to every 15 minutes. Experiment and see the different effects that you can achieve. When working out the actual length of the time lapse, I usually just work backwards. So if I know I want a 10 second time lapse video at 25 frames a second, that means I need to take 250 frames. At a 30 second exposure plus 5 second intervals, I know each shot takes 35 seconds. Times that by 250 frames and you get 8,750 seconds, which is 145 minutes or just shy of 2.5 hours. Changing the interval, the exposure time, even the amount of photos you're gonna take all have a huge impact on your actual time lapse. Basically, there's no magic setting, so it's all down to personal taste. So when you're done, you'll end up with hundreds, if not thousands of images. You can stitch them together in iMovie, whatever editing software you use, it might be Premiere, it might be Sony Vegas, Final Cut, whatever, just put them together and export off a video, you can be done. I like to push them a little bit further than that, which is why I use Adobe Lightroom. So you can see here, this is my raw image, this is why I shoot raw, is so I can push the image that much further. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring the highlights right the way up, I'm gonna bring my shadows right the way down, I'm gonna do a white point, so I press the Alt key, push it up to about there just to help the stars pop a little bit. Bring my black point down until I see something coming through. I can go a little bit further than that because I know it's a night sky. To about there. I'm gonna increase my clarity to 100. Increase my vibrance to about there, something like that. Maybe add a bit more contrast. Really make it stand out. Okay, if I scroll down, I click enable profile corrections. This just takes away a bit of barreling and a bit of vignetting. I can always add back a bit of vignetting if I want to. It might draw the eye a little bit further. Okay, that's it. I'll show you the before and after. So as you see, the image was pretty good in the first place. All I've done is make it pop that little bit further just so it really, really stands out. And then Control A, select all. Make sure the one that I've edited is selected first, hit sync. Make sure all of the boxes are ticked and hit synchronize. That will update all of your images in your sequence. As you can see down here, they're all slowly updating. Okay, to then stitch my images together, I simply go File, Export. I use a third-party plugin called LR Timelapse. You can just see here. You can go onto the website, buy it. It works perfectly with Lightroom. You can export 6K, 4K, whatever you want. So I put my sequence here, tree line, silhouette, and click export. LR Timelapse does the rest of the work. You then add a bit of dramatic music and you're done. Thanks for watching. Let me know what your time-lapse setup is and what software you use. I'm Cal Thomson. See you soon.